amigos! Welcome to Learning Spanish with Mica Gal. I'm Cristian Meneses Jacobs, tu profesora de español, your Spanish teacher. In today's lesson, we are going to learn Spanish pronouns and how to conjugate the verb ser. Let's begin with the Spanish pronouns. Remember that a pronoun is a word that takes the place of a noun. These are the pronouns you need to know in Spanish. Yo is used to refer to oneself. Tú is the familiar you that is used with people your age or younger. Usted is the formal you, and it is used to speaking with adults or authority figures. Él is used to refer to a male. This él with an accent is a pronoun, and it is different from the other él without an accent that we learned in previous lessons that it is a definite article. Ella is used to refer to a female. Nosotros is used for a group of males or a group of males and females. In Spanish, the male nouns and pronouns take precedence over the female. Nosotras is used for a group of females only. Vosotros is the plural familiar you, and it is mainly used in Spain to address a group of males and a group of males and females. Vosotras is used for a group of females. Ellos is used for a group of males and a group of males and females. Ellas is used for a group of females only. Ustedes is the plural formal you, and it is mainly used in Latin America to address a group of adults. And it is also used as a plural familiar you to address a group of females and males. Vamos a practicar. Let's practice. Repeat after me. Yo. Tú. Él. Ella. Usted. Nosotros. Nosotras. Vosotros. Vosotras. Ellos. Ellas. Ustedes. ¡Muy bien! Now let's practice substituting a noun for a pronoun. I will give you a noun and you're going to replace it with a pronoun. For example, if you're speaking to Señor López, you are going to use the formal you, and that is the pronoun usted. Now it's your turn. The verb to be is two verbs in Spanish, ser and estar. We're going to concentrate on ser. You can only use ser in the following situations. And to help you remember, we use the acronym DOCTOR. D is for date, as in hoy es lunes. O is for occupation, as in nosotras somos profesoras. C is for characteristics, as in tú eres alto. T is for time, as in son las dos. O is for origin, as in yo soy de Nicaragua. R is for religion, as in ellos son católicos. And it can also be used for relationship, as in ella es mi madre. When using the verb ser, you have to make sure that your sentences meet this criteria. Now let's talk about conjugating the verb ser using the pronouns we just learned. These are the singular forms of the verb ser, which refers to only one person. The conjugation soy refers to yo, yo soy. The conjugation eres refers to tú, the familiar you, tú eres. The conjugation es refers to three pronouns, él, ella, and usted, as in él es, ella es, usted es. Now these are the plural forms of the verb ser. somos refers to nosotros and nosotras. As in nosotros somos, nosotras somos. Sois is the conjugation for vosotros and vosotras. And remember, this is only used in Spain. Vosotros sois, vosotras sois. Son is the conjugation for three pronouns. Ellos, ellas, and ustedes. Ellos son, ellas son, ustedes son. Vamos a practicar. Let's practice. Repeat after me. Yo soy. Tú eres. Él es, ella es, usted es, nosotros somos, nosotras somos, vosotros sois, vosotras sois, ellos son, ellas son, ustedes son. ¡Muy bien! Let's practice using the correct conjugation of the present form of the verb ser. For example, las conductoras. You can use the pronoun ellas in place of las conductoras. The conjugation of the verb ser for ellas is son, as in las conductoras son. Now it's your turn to practice conjugating the verb ser. Remember that the pronoun determines the conjugation of the verb. ¡Excelente! Keep practicing the pronouns and the conjugations of the present form of the verb ser. And come back for lesson 10 when we are going to learn about date, the first part of doctor, which will include days of the week and months of the year. Leave me a message in the discussion section and let me know in what other ways I can help you learn Spanish. Please share and subscribe. ¡Hasta luego!